Hello everybody and welcome back. And now, in the previous videos, we have seen some of the post-exploitation modules that we can run against the target. Now those are just some of them. You can run basically a bunch of others as well, which we will not cover since there is no time for that. If you want to, you can check them out at the Metasploit modules basically directory, or you can just search post in the Metasploit framework console command. If you just open it right here with this. I will open it since we will need it, since in this video I will show you how you can do the attack over the internet. But before I do that, let me just show you how you can search all of the post-exploitation modules. Now basically once this opens, you just search post then /windows and it will give you all of the post-exploitation modules that you can use on Windows. So just type here search post /windows and it should print out all of the, let me just zoom it out once again, all of the modules that you can use on the Windows. These are all post-exploitation modules, as it says right here with post, and you can use them if you want to. For example, this could be interesting to you for if you wanted to check out the USB history. So we, for example, know that the USB that we plugged in before should appear in there. Now, I don't have a session open, so I won't be running that exploit, but you can check it out if you wanted to. But more about that later on. What we want to do right now is perform a port forwarding in order to be able to do this attack on any PC in the world. So how we do port forwarding? Well, open up your Firefox. You would need to access your router. So you need to know your router's username and password and enter it. And after you do that, basically you can just find the port forwarding section. So let me just show you. You just check out your router's IP. In my case, my router's IP is .1.1 and I just click on it. It will prompt me with a login screen. So I just type my username and password. We do not want to save it. And now, since everyone's router is different, what you want to find in your router is basically the port forwarding section. Now, I'm not even sure where is it in my, it should be somewhere in the, not wireless, it could be on the NAT. So NAT port forwarding, I found mine. And here you have set of rules that you want to specify in order to perform a port forwarding. So rule index, not really that important. Application, not important. What is important is the, well, this isn't really, no, not this thing. The protocol under that is important. So you want to send TCP right here. The start port number you want to set to the port that you want to forward. So let's say we want to forward 55555 and port number should also be 55555. Local IP address is the IP address of your Kali Linux machine, which currently, if I run ifconfig, is the dot, let me just find it, is .1.4. So we just type here your local IP address, you check it out with the ifconfig command, and then you specify it in the local IP address. Then the start port local can also be 55555, since these are the same options as well as the previous ones, which are the start and the end port. So once you select the port number that you want to port forward on your local machine and the IP address of your local machine, as we can see right here, what you want to click on is submit, or basically whatever it says for you. So once we submit, we can see that right now I successfully made a port forward for this IP address on this port, which is good. Right now that we port forwarded, the only thing you want to do right now, which is different from the previous attacks, is basically change the IP address of the local host in the MSF Vinom payload creation into the global IP address, or basically into the, your public IP address right here. So if you just type here, what is my IP? My IP. It will print out what is your public IP address, as it says right here, which currently for me is this one. And only thing you need to do is specify in your payload creation under, instead of the lhost to be your local IP address, which is .1.4, you want to specify this IP address right here. So let me show you how to do that. If you just go right here, change root, we check the print working directory and we create the payload. So msf wannon minus p, we want to use the same meterpreter or the same payload as before, so meterpreter reverse TCP. And right here, lhost equals, instead of specifying local IP address, we what you want to paste is your public IP address right here. The L port, you want to set the L port to the port that you forwarded, which in our case is 5555. In your case, if you specify the different port, just use different port instead. So L port equals 5555. And then after that, we specify everything the same, so file.exe, and then we want to specify it to be, let's say, vanshell.exe. So we wait for this to create our own payload, and after it creates this payload, what you can do is basically you can send it to anyone you want. You can send it basically to a different continent on some other PC, and what that PC will do, it will perform a public IP connection and it will try to connect to this IP on this port, and our router, since it has a rule that this port is forwarded to the .1.4 local IP address, will forward this connection to our Kali Linux machine. So now if I type here ls, we can see that the vanshell.exe is created. And all I want to do is plug in my USB drive, so Kingston Data Travel. Or you can actually do it over Apache 2 if you want to, it doesn't really matter. And what I want to do is copy vanshell.exe, oops, vanshell.exe into, well, let me just do it like this, so since I need to specify it in a regular terminal. So what I want to do is basically copy vanshell.exe into my USB drive. You can do it manually or you can do it with the command like this. And now we have our vanshell here. So after we do that, we just turn off the USB drive, we unmount it, we also uncheck it right here, so it goes to connect to our Windows 10 machine. And after that, what we want to do, let me just see if it will pop up right here, or I have to re-plug it in. So let me just do it like this. It is not popping up, it doesn't matter. What we will do is we will just go right here, and here is the vanshell. I put it on my desktop. And what I want to do is basically specify a listener right now, same as before. So we use exploit multi-handler, set payload to be the Windows 64-bit meterpreter, reverse TCP. Now I'm going over this fast since I already covered it. Oops, I made a typo, so meterpreter. And now show options, we can see everything is set except lhost, so set lhost to be your local IP address, right here. And what you want to do is just type your exploit JZ, it will run it in the background, and if we run this right here, you will see that in a few seconds we will get a reverse shell back. Whoops, the reason why we are not getting it, I just noticed right now, is because I specified right here the L port to be 4444 instead for it to be 5555, which is specified in the port forwarding rule. So let us do this once again, use exploit multi-handler. Let me just see jobs, so I killed this job that I ran, so I killed the first listening on port 4444. And I show my options, let us see if everything is set. And now we want to change the L port to be 5555. So, now that we did all of that, now we can exploit JZ. We can run the meterpreter, or pardon me, run the listening. And now, if we run this, we will get the connection from our Windows 10 machine. And now, this will work for any machine on the world. in the world. So basically, wherever that machine is, it will be able to connect to you, since we port forwarded our port to router. And we can see right now we are not even getting the connection from a local IP, we are getting connection from the public IP. As we can see, if I go sessions minus I1, get user ID, we can see that we successfully were able to exploit a target machine that is not on our local network, even though my Windows 10 machine really is. But the process is looking like this. So this, with this process, you will be able to connect any machine in the world. So that would be about it for this tutorial. I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope I see you in the next one. Bye.